Ladies and gentlemen, I'm sorry that I have to go immediately after my speech. Just bear with me. And this is an important topic has been taken by the Occupational Association of India. As all of you know, that this Occupations Act, first adopted by 1950 by the WHO, and different law was enacted by the ILO and WHO. Ultimately, it was emerged in 1955, combined legislation was made. And as you know that WHO defines the health, not only mental, physical, but social well-being, not only absence of the disease as such. Now what the topic today is a basic health system in the occupational health. I think this is the topic symposium. I was not knowing what are the topics. So just now I was asking what I'm supposed to talk about this. So I just told that basic health system. If you see, we have physical, biological, chemical hazards, many hazards in that health system in the occupational places. People are working in the agriculture, people are working in the mines, and everyone, whether it is working in the offices, the basic health system everyone requires, any place. But it varies from place to place. The occupational health, like somebody is working in the construction site, the person should not fall. This is the most important. Where the more noise is going on, where there is a hearing loss, the hearing loss should not occur. Where is some sort of biological things like anthrax, toxin can cause the disease. So first of all, in any basic health services, the most important is the preventions, how we can prevent it. So if we can take all the precautionary measure which can prevent the accident to occur, or in the long run, if the person is working like oil sectors, and if they are working, supposed to work in 48 hours, but people work more than 60 hours in a week time, so their exposure to chemicals much more high. And if the exposure to chemicals much more high, for sometimes it affects the lungs, even the people are working in the space. So the basic occupational health service, first of all, is a prevention. And prevention varies from person place to place. Suppose in the agriculture they are spraying some insecticides. The people have to take care of, otherwise some insecticides are poisonous, can lead to some damage, can die even the people. When it was started a long time back, I remember 1970, when the people used to die because of this, somebody used to bear it, and I used to hear in the village that people has died because of insecticides they have drink. So these are the occupational hazards which occur. So first of all, any principle of the health system in occupation is the prevention. So wherever it is, there prevention has to be taken. Now comes the basic health system, which we all lack, is that if you have to, we have to have basic health system in the system. As you know, our Ayurvedic system is one of the best, naturopathy, lifestyle. So we have to taught the basic lifestyle of all the peoples, wherever they are working, whether they are working in the office, or wherever they are working in the mines, or whether they are working in the agriculture system, or whether they are working in some factory. In our India, in the India itself, director general is made for the factory and docks, and they make the rule and regulation. But beyond that, it is required. It is not only factory and dock which require the legislation, but even the people who are working in the offices, there is a psychological, psychosocial hazards, mental tension, lots of work, lots of stress, which causing lots of problems. Then person working in the tobacco field. So regular health checkup is the most important among all, if we have to give the basic health services system. So all the hospital at the moment is when you reach, then they treat. The time has come, there has to be some preventive and promotive type of hospitals is required in this country. and we require a lifestyle change in the whole things, in like normal diet, lots of vegetables, no smoking, no alcohol, exercise. We don't want that these people who are doing the physical work has to do the exercise, but we can suggest them to do the breathing exercise so they can, you increase the work cultures, working culture, working capacity you can increase. Because the whole purpose of the occupational health is not only to see the care of the workers or the workforce, but also to productivity should increase, the culture, working culture should be such that it generates the environmental is a social environment. It should be very brotherly environments. So basically the mind setup has to be very cordial among all the workers, and we don't have to see only the workers, we have to see their family also beyond that, because this is the important. Because if the workers who has lots of tension at home, and if you come at the work, definitely that will cause lots of problem. It is a big topics. Basic health life support is a big topics, because it starts from the preventions to taking care of the workers, to taking care of their family, to having regular checkup of the family, to having the history of the family, what, whether he's suffering from family or suffering from hypertension or diabetic mellitus. We can take the precautionary measure for that. We can tell them patients how to prevent the pre-diabetic to become the diabetic. We can make them, at least we cannot control the essential hypertension, but definitely we can delay the essential hypertension. We can decrease the dose of the essential hypertension drugs. These are the things, if we know the history, the basic life support can be started, basic health system can be started at very early age. And with this system, Rajivji has asked what the government of India is doing for all these things, how the basic life support comes. Just to inform you of the audience, that at the moment, Ministry of Health and Family Welfare has chosen 6 districts in the country as a pilot project, starting from West Bengal in Darjeeling, Bihar in Gaya, Lakhimpur Kheri in UP, Bhilwara in Rajasthan, Krishnanagar in Andhra Pradesh, and Sundanagar in Gujarat, where we have taken this scope, and we are trying to change the lifestyles. And by lifestyle, we are controlling the diet, we are teaching the yoga, and we are going to search house to house. Any patient suffering from diabetic, any patient suffering from tuberculosis, any patient suffering from cancer, or hypertension, or cardiovascular disease, any respiratory disease, we are trying to get them tested and treated. So we have Ministry of Health and Family Welfare with the system of AYUSH. We have taken as a pilot project to make this district healthy district. As you know, every member of parliament has taken one house, one village to make the healthy. Our prime minister has taken this 100 village in the Varanasi districts, just to inform you, the audience. So in the same way, the Ministry of Health and Family Welfare with the AYUSH system, we have taken the 6 districts to make it the disease-free, and how we can change the whole system of the medicine by the lifestyle change, behavioral change, meditation, yoga, food habits, drinking habits, no smoking, how we can change the whole things, and meditations, definitely. Because all the things ultimately put the stress. So basic health system which we have to do in this occupation health is to see all the factors. First of all, the prevention, then their health checkup, and if there is a family history, more health checkup, and we can prevent the disease to occur in the family with some disease which is given by the genetically, we can delay it, not prevent, but at least we can delay by the lifestyle change. And definitely having a regular checkup to all the patients, all the persons who are working in the workplace, any place. I'm not telling that working in the mines, working in the agriculture, working in the factory, working in the dock, even the people who are working in the offices also required to be regular checkup, because as asbestos or any chemicals causing the problem to physics or any fall from the construction site gets the damage to the limbs and they become the handicapped. Even the wherever there is a noise, because hearing loss is one of the important factors in the USA. Hearing loss is a significant amount. So these are the things which we have to take a precaution. So basic things is a prevention and then definitely checkup. And I think, I don't know whether I have spoken correctly or not, the topics which you have given to me, because just I came to know, okay, this is the topics. I thought I have to just say general thing. And Dr. Ramteka also didn't tell me what you are coming for. He didn't tell me that what you are coming for.
He had trust in your versatility, actually.
So I just asked Rajiv Jain, what is the topics? And he told me this is the topics. So I thought, okay, let me say whether I am able to speak that part or not. But this is my understanding about the occupation, the basic health system, which we can do it.
No question.
No doubt what DGH has spoken shows that how much deep understanding of the healthcare system that he's managing. And by the way, health is a state subject. Central government is only in the advisory capacity, yet Ministry of Health and Family Welfare has gone in and started interventions to have a convergence of services within the health sector. Today, the big revolution, as he mentioned, Ayush integration with the existing modern scientific system of medicine is happening for the first time in our country. It is not looked down upon. And as Dr. Ramani Parikh earlier had been saying, things are changing for the better, isn't it, sir?
Yeah, not only that, I just want to inform all of you, our target is to make 100 integrated hospital all over the country in coming 3 years of my service. So this is the things, integration with the Ayush and the medicines.
Great.
And we can help the peoples. Great. And with these viewers, thanks a lot for calling me here, and thanks to audience.
We're really grateful, sir, for sparing your time for this association.
Pardon me for leaving the